Welcome to Ethiopian Embassy. This is a newly built facility. We just moved in almost a year ago. This is the first satellite that was launched. Ethiopian remote sensing satellite.
Provided by the Ministry of Ecology and Environment of the People's Republic of China. Ethiopia is one of the oldest countries in Africa, and I would like to know what are the origins of Ethiopia.
The national motto now is Ethiopia is a land of origins. One thing that makes us a land of origin is, of course, coffee. But much more than that, archaeological and anthropological studies and findings show the oldest human fossil was found in Ethiopia. So we can, on the basis of the evidence, we can claim that we are origin of human beings. I think that's one thing, but in terms of civilization, again, we have ancient civilization, long history of over 3,000 years now.
What will make and how you will describe the Ethiopian identity in Africa?
In African identity, every African country has its unique culture, its unique tradition. We are a country that still maintain our own calendar, which is unique, our own alphabet, our own time counting, and there are things again that make us, in that regard, African but Ethiopian.
Your country is fascinating.
It's very fascinating, I would say. For instance, because of the calendar I have just said, we have our own New Year, which actually is on September 11 or 12, depending on the leap year. So unlike the rest of the world, where there are few other countries which have their own New Year, including China, and they have their own New Year Spring Festival, but ours is on September 11 or 12. These are Ethiopian export items, actually. We have several products that we export to Chinese market.
Do you shop online?
My son does it for me, and my assistant, Chinese assistant.
What do you like to buy online in China?
Everything.
Everything. You can find everything, right?
Yeah, I mean... Today, China, I mean, the e-commerce, the digital... World economy in Chinese is just amazing.
I cannot imagine life without Taobao and Tmall.
Absolutely. You see, you want anything, you get it, and you get it immediately. This is the officially used Ethiopian alphabet.
More than 3,000 years
yes,
of
history. Yeah. If you want to write my name in Amharic, okay. I start Te.
Te.
And my second, Teshome, my name is Teshome now. So
yes.
I go to She, and then I have She, Te, Sho, Sho, Teshome. And then Me, Teshome. So we don't have vowels actually, we use Te, Sho, Me. CGTN.
Mm. So this is CGTN.
Yeah. CGTN.
Wow.
Gazetteños, journalists, and Miss Ioana, with your crew, you are most welcome to Ethiopian Embassy, and thank you for coming. Then I have my name here, Teshome Toga, Ambassador. That's what I wrote.
Oh, smells like heaven. So what's the history behind the discovery of coffee in Ethiopia?
We had someone named actually Kahalil, So he is he was a herder of goats in a province of Ethiopia called Kaffa. His goats actually ate leaves of coffee. So he saw a very strange character or behavior of the goats after eating the leaves. So he started asking himself why. And he saw that the goats actually ate that leaves. So he himself started trying it, what kind of effect it would have in him. Mm-hmm. So that is how it started actually. And that's why we say that we are birthplace or a place where coffee was discovered or originated. And it has become part of Ethiopia's culture.
Do you usually drink coffee in small cups?
Yes, normally we have different coffee cups actually, but they are small in size. And that's how Ethiopian coffee is served actually.
China and Ethiopia are totally different from a cultural point of view. How do you navigate cultural barriers here in China?
I served my country in this capacity in different six different countries. China is the sixth country. Frankly speaking, except for the language barrier, I never had any difficulty to settle in. And of course, the hospitality, the generosity of the Chinese people, the Chinese government also matters. But on the other hand, I think my exposure also helped me a lot. Not only me, but my family did not have any difficulty to settle down actually here in China.
Are there any aspects of Chinese culture that you think people back home in Ethiopia will be interested in?
There is a very fascinating family orientation in the Chinese society. Every Chinese Spring Festival, you see millions of Chinese moving to what they call, this is my city, this is my province, my home city, my home. I think that's interesting. And we have similar thing actually in Ethiopia. If not all, but there are communities in Ethiopia where people come all over the world for New Year or for a certain occasion in that community. So family orientation, very strong, I think, bond of link as a family is one thing things that Ethiopians would associate themselves with.
Ambassador, thank you so much for today. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Please, you are always most welcome to Ethiopian Embassy.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
A wonderful
thank
day.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
See you soon.